Hi friends, welcome back to Angular unit testing series. In this series, I'm talking about unit testing in Angular using Jasmine framework. In the last video, I have explained about how we can test HTTP services. In this video, let's see about how we can test an Angular component. Let me use the same application which I used so far. In this, let me choose the home component. Let me explain the spec file code which is generated by the CLI. Here, we have only one test case to test, whether the component instance has been created successfully. For that, we can see a variable named component has been used, which is of type home component. And another variable named fixture of type component fixture has been used. Fixture is used in many ways in testing the component. Even we can use the fixture to create the component instance. And then we can see two before each blocks. First one is an asynchronous block and the second one is a synchronous block. In the asynchronous block, the testing module is configured, and in the synchronous block, the instance of the component is created. But why do we need to configure the testing module in the asynchronous block? While testing the services, we have configured the testing module in the synchronous block only. What is the need for asynchronous block here? Let me explain. While testing the services, we just need to configure the testing module. But here, we need to configure testing module and then we need to call compile components function. This compile components function returns a promise and so it is asynchronous. If you are not waiting for this promise to resolve, this code may execute before the component instance is created and so our test may fail. That is the reason we are executing this code inside the asynchronous block. Instead of doing this way, let me show you another way. Let me create a before each block. Inside that, let me configure the testing module. Let me declare the component here. And then, now I need to call the compile components function. But this time, let me resolve the promise. And here, let me create the fixture. And then, let me create the instance of the component. It appears to be good, but it is not. Now also, this code will be executed before the promise code is executed. And so our test will fail. So to fix this, either I can use the JavaScript async await like this, or we can use wait for async utility from this library. We can wrap our code inside wait for async function. Now the component instance is created correctly, and so our test is getting passed. Let me also show you how we can test the DOM elements. Usually in most of the projects, these kind of presentation components will not be tested. But in few projects, these will be tested to achieve code coverage. I'll be explaining about code coverage in a separate video. Now let me show you how we can test this paragraph element. To test this, I can get help from the fixture. First, let me create a new variable EL of type debug element. And here, let me create this using the debug element from the fixture. I am going to create a new spec. Inside that, I can use this debug element to query the DOM elements. I am going to use the query all API, in which I can use the by utility, which is having a predicate function called CSS, to which I can pass any CSS selectors. In our case, we don't have a class or ID. And so let me use the element selector itself. So let me pass P to select all the paragraph elements. This is going to give us an array. We can access the first element, in which we need to use the native element to get access to the actual element. And then we can use the text content to access the content inside this element. And we can use the expect utility to make sure this text content is matching with the expected content. In our case, it is going to be home works. And so we can see our test is passing. Let me show you another example. Let me create a button. This time let me have a class. And let me make this button disabled. And in the spec file, let me create a new element. This time I can access the element using the class name. and I can use the expect utility to check whether the button is disabled. If we miss to specify the disabled attribute here, our test will fail. And let me show you another example also. Let me create an image element with some image source. In spec file, I can get the image element. And I can validate the source to be equal to the expected URL. And so we can see our test is getting passed. If we get a different image, our test case will fail. Finally, let me show you one last example. This time, I'm not going to hardcode the value in the template. Instead, I'm going to keep the value in the component and I'm going to bind that to the template. Okay, let's see how we can test this. First, let me copy this and change it as per our need. Everything is same except this. Now, this is not going to be static. This can be coming from a database. Need not to be same always. We may get different value. So, how can we test this? We can set a mock data and expect to be on the DOM. But we can see our test is failing. That is because we have set the data in the component, but this will not trigger the change detection. And so we need to trigger the change detection manually. We can see this code here. This has been added by the CLI. So we need to add this code to trigger the change detection after we set the data in the component. Hope you understood how we can test an Angular component. That's all for today. Please like this video and support me. I'll be back with next concept soon. Thank you. Bye.